Have a great day, students! In this video, we're going to talk about what is critical reading and reading strategy. Reading critically does not necessarily mean being critical of what you read. Hindi yan kapag sinabi natin critical reading ay kailangan you are critical on what you read. Both reading and thinking critically don't mean being critical about some idea, argument, or piece of writing, claiming that it is somehow faulty or incorrect or hindi tama. Ibig sabihin, ang pagbabasa at pag-iisip ng critical ay hindi nangangahulugan ng pagiging critical tungkol dun sa ideas, arguments, or piece of writing na meron ka. Hindi yung pagsasabi na may mali or hindi tama sa binabasa mo. When we say critical reading, it means engaging in what you read, pagsali or pag-relate ng sarili mo dun sa binabasa mo by asking yourself questions such as, what is the author trying to say? Ano ba ang gustong sabihin ng author or may akda? Or what is the main argument being presented? Ano ba ang pangunahing pinag-uusapan or sabihin na nating problema sa binabasa mo? And it involves presenting reason argument that evaluates and analyzes of what you have read. Kaya kailangan ito ng matinding pagsusuri sa binabasa mo. Remember, to read critically is to exercise your judgment about what you are reading. When reading academic material, you will be faced with the author's interpretation and opinion. Different authors will have different interpretation. Kapag nagbabasa ka kasi ng isang academic material, makikita mo dyan yung interpretation or paliwanag at opinion ng author or may akda. You should always examine what you are reading critically and look for limitations, omissions, yung mga salita na hindi naman ganun kahalaga sa binabasa mo, inconsistencies, knowing similarities, oversights, or yung mga nababasa mong hindi maayos, and arguments, yung against what you are reading. In academic circles, you are a student, so you will be expected to understand different viewpoints and make your own judgments based on what you have read. So the bottom line here is critical reading goes farther than just being satisfied with a text says. Ibig sabihin, kapag sinabi natin critical reading, hindi ka dapat kontento sa sinasabi ng binabasa mo. It also involves reflecting on what the text describes and analyzing what the text actually means in the context of your studies. Dapat sinusuri mo mabuti or inaaral kung ano ba talaga ang sinasabi ng isang teksto. And as a critical reader, you should reflect on, first, what the text says. After critical reading a piece, you should be able to take notes. Dapat marunong kang kumuha ng mga importanteng details sa binabasa mo, paraphrasing the key points like writing it in your own words. Dapat hindi mo lang sinusulat yung mga importanteng detalye. Dapat isinusulat mo rin yan galing mismo sa sarili mong salita. Second, what the text describes. You should be confident that you have understood the text sufficiently to be able to use your own examples and compare and contrast with other writing on the subject in hand. Siguraduhin mo rin dapat na naintindihan mo ang binabasa mo. Kasi hindi ka makakapagbigay ng halimbawa or examples kung kulang ang pag-unawa mo sa tekstong binabasa mo. At hindi mo rin siya maihahambing sa ibang teksto dahil hindi mo siya lubos na naiintindihan. And lastly, interpretation of the text. This means that you should be able to fully analyze the text and state a meaning for the text as a whole. Sa reader, pagkatapos mong i-analyze ang buong teksto na binasa mo, dapat kaya mong bigyan ng kahulugan ang buong teksto. That is what critical reading means, being able to reflect or kaya mong mag-isip ng malalim on what a text says, what it describes or ipinapakita, and what means or ibig sabihin by scrutinizing or pagsusuri sa style and structure of the writing, the language used as well as the content. Next is critical thinking is an extension of critical reading. Thinking critically in the academic sense involves being open-minded, using judgment and discipline to process what you are learning about without letting your personal bias or opinion from the arguments. Pag sinabi natin critical thinking, dapat bukas ang iyong isip, lalo na sa pag-a-apply ng iyong mga nalalaman. At hindi mo dapat pinapaboran ang sarili mong opinion na inilalahad sa teksto. Critical thinking also involves being rational and aware of your own feelings on the subject, being able to reorganize your thoughts, prior knowledge, and understanding to accommodate new ideas or viewpoints. That's why critical reading and critical thinking are the foundations of true learning and personal development. Furthermore, critical thinking is the ability to think clearly and rationally, understanding the logical connection between ideas. It has been the subject of much debate and thought since the time of early Greek philosophers such as Plato and Socrates, and has continued to be a subject of discussion in the modern age. For example, the ability to recognize fake news. It might be described as the ability to engage in reflective and independent thinking. Yan ang pinakamahalaga sa critical thinking. Nagkakaroon ka ng kakayahan alamin ang fake news sa totoong balita. In essence, critical thinking requires you to use your ability to reason. It is about being an active learner rather than a passive recipient of information. Sa critical thinking kasi ay nagkakaroon ka ng kakayahan na mangatwiran at alamin ang tama kaysa dun sa tumatanggap ka lang ng information na sinasabi sa iyo. And you as a critical thinker, you rigorously question ideas and assumptions rather than accepting them at face value. You will always seek to determine whether the ideas, arguments, and findings represent the entire picture. Kapag sinabi kasi nating you are a critical thinker, nandyan yung lagi kang nagtatanong sa mga ideas ng iba, inaalam mo kung ano ang tama. And the most important of all, critical thinkers identify, analyze, and solve problems systematically rather than by intuition or instinct. Someone with critical thinking skills can understand the links between ideas, yung connections ng iba't ibang ideas. Number 2, determine the importance and relevance of arguments and ideas. Mean ang importance at ugnayan ng mga ideas. And next is recognize, build, and appraise arguments. Kaya mong kilalanin, bumuo at suriin ang mga argumento sa teksto. Number 4, identify inconsistencies and errors in reasoning. Tukuyin ang mga hindi pagkakapare-pareho at pagkakamali sa pangangatwiran. And number 5, approach problems in a consistent and systematic way. Number 6, reflect on the justification of their own assumptions, beliefs, and values. Aralan ng mabuti ang kanilang palagay, paniniwala, at pagpapahalaga sa teksto. So, in general speaking, critical thinking is thinking about things in a certain way so as to arrive at the best possible solution in the circumstances that the thinker is aware of. In more everyday language, it is a way of thinking about whatever is presently occupying your mind so that you come to the best possible conclusion. Developing a reading strategy. In formal learning situation, it is required to read and critically think about a lot of information from different sources. It is important, therefore, that you not only learn to read critically, but also efficiently. The first step to efficient reading is to become selective. If you cannot read all the books on recommended reading list, you need to find a way of selecting the best text for you. To start with, you need to know what you are looking for. You can then examine the contents, page, or index of a book or journal to ascertain whether a chapter or article is worth pursuing further. Once you have selected a suitable piece, the next step is to speed read. Speed reading is also often referred to as a skim reading or scanning. Once you have identified a relevant piece of text, like a chapter in a book, you should scan the first few sentences of each paragraph to gain an overall impression of subject areas it covers. Scan reading essentially means that you know what you are looking for. You identify the chapters or section most relevant to you and ignore the rest. Ang ibig sabihin ng scan reading ay alam mo kung ano ang iyong hinahanap, kung ano lang ang kailangan mo, yun lang ang binabasa mo. When you speed read, you are not aiming to gain a full understanding of the arguments or topics raised in the text. It is simply a way of determining what the text is about. When you find a relevant or interesting section, you will need to slow your reading speed dramatically, allowing you to gain a more in-depth understanding of the arguments raised. Even when you slow your reading down, it may well be necessary to read passages several times to gain a full understanding. Kaya ang speed reading ay mabilis ng pagbabasa, hindi mo goal dyan na intindihin ang buong teksto. Ito ay paraan lang ng pagtukoy kung tungkol saan ang teksto. And that's all for this video and all about critical reading and reading strategy. Hope you learned something from this video. If there's a need for clarification or questions or a part of the video you don't understand, just let me know. Thank you for watching.